Sometimes I question whether this shit matters. Putting substance into something in the world, so used to instant gratification. I found this instrumental on my phone while on vacation. Each sent it a year ago or so. I probably heard it before, slept on it, you know. Shit don't always connect as soon as you press play. At times you gotta step away, do some living. Let time provide a new prescription given to a vision. I dibble-dabble in a few religions. My homie constantly telling me about Quran, putting me on. I read a few pages and recognize the wisdom in it. But I ain't got the discipline for sticking with it. Now I'm on the way to London, got a show for 7 digits. I'm wondering just when did I become my biggest critic. I wanna be my biggest fan, like how I was when did nobody know my jam. Today my son said that, let go my hand. Reminding me one day he's gonna be his own man. And my job is to make sure he's equipped. I gotta make sure he not no bitch, cause it was time to try him. If I said I was the toughest growing up, I would be lying. I had a fear of getting punched while everybody eyeing. After that, a constant fear of dying by gunshot wound or other violent type of illness. I kept a tough demeanor on the surface, but was mostly just pretending. Luckily, my breath was working way more often than not. But sometimes a nigga pull my car, trying to expose me for a fraud. But with my reputation at stake, I was scuffling just to save face. A couple wins, couple losses, some broken up too quick to call it. My last scrap was with Puff Daddy, who would've thought it? I bought that nigga album in 7th grade and played it so much, you would've thought my favorite rapper was Puff. Back then, I ain't no shit, now I know too much. Ignorance is bliss, and innocence is just ignorance before it's introduced to currency and clips. A bad mix to have a nigga serving 3 to 6. Shit.
So just.
Teach us how to lead. Show us how to love.